In Greater Idlib, the defences of Hayat Tahrir al-Sham and other favourites of the foreign powers supporting Syrian democracy are collapsing. On February 5th, the Syrian army, supported by Russian air power, took control of a number of villages in southeastern Idlib and southwestern Aleppo, including Resafa, al-Dahabia, Ajlas, Talafi and Judidat Talafi. They besieged a Turkish observation post established near Tal Torgan and reached another one near al-Sheikh Mansour. Late on the same day, the army's Tiger forces captured the eastern entrance to Sarakib and established fire control over the open roads leading from the town. According to local sources, Hayat Tahrir al-Sham and other al-Qaeda, so-called freedom fighters, started fleeing the town. The Turkish army had stuck several observation posts right in the area, but these apparently did not help. Early on February the 6th, pro-government forces seized the area of Duwaya, cutting off the M5 highway north of Sarakib. Thus, the road through Saramin remained the only way to flee for militants remaining in the town. However, it is under the fire control of the Syrian army. Several hours after this, government forces took full control of Sarakib. Sarakib Nahiya is the largest sub-district of the Idlib district of the province. The sub-district is located on the crossroad of the M4 and M5 highways. Its pre-war population was approximately 88,000. The fall of Sarakib into the hands of Damascus and its allies will allow government troops to continue the operation clearing the entire M5 highway and open the road to Idlib city itself. Right on cue, while the Syrian army was storming Sarakib, the Israeli Air Force delivered a wide-scale strike on targets in the countryside of the Syrian capital Damascus and in the province of Deraa. The Al-Kiswa area, Marj al-Sultan, Baghdad Bridge and the area south of Isra were among the confirmed targets of the attack. Syria's state media claimed that the Syrian air defense shot down most of the Israeli missiles before they were able to reach their targets. Pro-Israeli sources claim that the strike successfully hit Iran-related targets, destroying weapon depots and HQs of Iranian-backed forces. The Israeli leadership once again officially confirmed its participation in the Club of Terrorism Supporters in Syria. Another member of the Al-Qaeda Rescue Rangers is Mr. Recep Tayyip Erdogan. On February the 5th, he vowed that Turkey would deploy locally made air defense systems along the border with Syria. The president did not provide many details on the matter, but the aforementioned systems were likely the Haisar A low-altitude air defense system, which would be deployed along the border with Idlib. Additionally, Erdogan delivered an ultimatum to Syria, claiming that if the Syrian regime will not retreat from Turkish observation posts in Idlib in February, Turkey itself will be obliged to make this happen. In other words, the Turkish president threatened to declare war on Syria if the Syrian army does not withdraw from the territory it liberated from terrorists.